Hello Scrappers, today I'll show you why old is not only gold but it's also palladium. I have this old board, really old one, and let's remove all the elements together and let's see what we have. Let's start with this SWOT chips. This is from 1984, it's a Russian one. I'll just put them aside when I remove them, and this is the second Russian one. But more interesting is, what are these slots? Look at them. They're so nicely gold plated, both of them. And I think they buy this by the number of the pins. So just imagine how thick is the gold plating if you buy a slot counting the number of the pins. Another Russian I see. And this is the fourth one. Probably they have good gold content inside. But the most beautiful I see is this Tesla, because look at the gold Rex. It's so nice. Gold plated Rex. This Tesla I see. I will remove the plastic of all these slots. And what else we have here? We have some Eproms. These Eproms are from 1979 AMD Eproms. Look at this. Wow. Pretty old ones. I mean, I was born after this year, so these were created, manufactured before I was born. These AMD Eproms. No gold inside. But I think this will not go for scrapping, this will be for my collection. Okay, let's check the white ones now. Let's check the white slots. Do we have gold in them too? Or are they like the green ones? Yes, same story. Look at this nice gold plating. I'll just show you like this to have a better view of these gold pins. So all of them have these nice gold plated pins, and these are really old ones. Also, we have these capacitors. These capacitors, the brown ones, they're Bulgarian and they have high palladium content. So I'll just put them separately. I'll find a small cup and I'll just put them separately. But this is definitely something I collect from these old boards. What else I see here? I see these switches. Usually this type of switches, they're used when you have a bus like this to control the speed of this bus. And that's why they usually have really good gold plating inside. Let me open one of them, if I can do this easily. So these are the gold plated switches inside. These are not good. Probably these are not Russian or Bulgarian ones. But usually there is a good catch inside of them. But these ones don't look as yellowish as the other ones. What else? We have this. Always check the transistors. We have these green transistors here. Put this here. So when you see transistors, just quickly cut them and check inside. Here can be gold plated. So this is a really quick test. So green ones are not gold plated. Let me take one of the gray ones and check quickly. No, and you see there is no gold plating. So that's fine, but it's good to check. Probably we have maybe some silver inside. When I'm looking at this color, looks like, but I collect these ones that contain gold, because it's usually quite thick gold plating inside of them. Okay, so what I will do now, I will quickly remove all these components and show you how much capacitors, pins and chips we can collect from this small vintage board from 1985 probably. Okay, I'm done with this board. So look at it. What is left, I will remove with my hot air gun. And I usually put these boards on batches like 10 and remove the chips from them with my hot air gun, also the slots. But what is left, they're at about 15 really good ICs, some Russian ones, this K series, this E. So these are really good, and probably you are able to see some gold plating that is visible here on the decks. So that's left from the board. But what we got? We got some really good ICs. These are Russian ones. Some really good Eproms from 1979 AMD. This beautiful Tesla IC. One nice surprise was hidden. This is a resistor. This is SP5. So this contains palladium inside. About the crystal oscillators. It's a long story, and I have a question to you. Have you ever tried to recover silver from them? Because I did. And the result was something like 6-7 grams from 1 kilogram. And just imagine the effort needed to break 1 kilogram of these and take out this. It's only in the middle. There is a small piece that contains silver. So if silver gets to be $200 per gram, definitely I'll go for them, but not now. Let's say it in this way. So I'll just stockpile this. What else we have? We have some diodes. We have some switches that contain gold plated fingers. We have some transistors that probably contain some silver. All these goes into different piles. I have pile for gold containing switches. I have a pile for silver containing elements. I stockpile them. As I said, I'll process them if silver goes really crazy. Crazier than now. And what is really important? Look here. These are my MLCCs. These are Bulgarian capacitors. Let me put here on the scale, this watch glass. And let's check how many grams we have of these. So from this small board, we recovered 5.5 grams of MLCCs. I'm not sure if you can see the reading of the scale, but it's 5.59. So these MLCCs have really, really high palladium content. And I stockpile them because who knows, palladium may turn to be even more expensive than it is now. It already jumped from 200 to $2,000. So who knows in the future what will happen. And maybe the most interesting are these pins. Look at the gold-plated pins that I recovered. They're at about 9 grams, 7.9 grams. But these gold-plated pins have more gold than maybe 100 grams or 1 kilogram of modern ones. So look at the gold plating. It looks so thick, so yellowish. That's how thick gold plating looks like. So guys, hope you like this video. And now that's another good example that old boards can give you more than the modern ones. But just scrap old useless boards. Never scrap old good boards. You can sell them for much, much more money than the scrap you'll find inside. Thanks for watching. Keep scrapping and enjoy collecting beautiful, beautiful ICs like this one. Thank you. Bye.